Lord Jesus Christ and thy Holy Spirit, enable them to walk in all thy commandments and to fulfill those things which are that are well pleasing unto thee. For if a man does these things, he shall find life in them. Inscribe him in the book of life, and unite him to thy flock of thy inheritance, and thy holy name may be glorified in him, together with that of thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and of thy life-giving creating Spirit. Let thine eyes ever regard him with mercy, and let thine ears hearken unto the voice of his supplication. Make him to rejoice in the works of his hands, and all that are in all his generation, that he may give thanks unto thee, and worship and glorify thy great and exalted name, and praise thee continually all the days of his life. For all the hosts of heaven praise thee, and thine is the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord laid thee under man, O devil, he who came into the world and dwelt among men, that he might overthrow the tyranny and rescue mankind, who also upon the tree did triumph over the adverse powers when the sun was darkened, and the earth did quake, and the graves were opened, and the body of the saints arose, who also destroyed death by death, and overthrew him who is exercised in the dominion of death, that is he, the devil. I adjure thee by God, who has revealed the tree of life, and who has arrayed in the ranks of the cherubim and the flaming sword which burneth everywhere to guard it, be thou under man, for I adjure thee by him who walked upon the surface of the sea, as it were dry land, and laid it upon his man in the tempests of the winds, whose glance dried up in the deep, and whose interdict maketh the mountains to melt away. For he now through us doth lay thee under man. Be afraid, be gone, and depart from this creature, and return not again. Neither hide thyself from him, neither seek thou to meet him, nor to influence him either by night or by day, either in the morning or the noonday. But depart hence to thine own Tartarus, and to the great day of judgment which is prepared. Fear God, who sitteth upon the cherubim, and who looketh upon the deeps, before whom tremble the angels, archangels, thrones, dominions, principalities, and authorities, powers, and the many eyed cherubim, and the six-winged seraphim, who before whom tremble the heavens, and earth, and the sea, and all that is therein. Be gone and depart from this sealed, newly chosen warrior, Christ our God, for I adjure thee by him who walketh upon the wings of the winds, and maketh his angel spirits, and his ministers a flame of fire. Be gone and depart from this creature with all the powers and angels.
Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
God, holy, who's holy and terrible and glorious, who is unsearchable and inscrutable in all his works and might, who has ordained for thee, O devil, the penalty of eternal punishment, he through us, his unworthy servant, doth command thee and all thy confederate hosts to depart from him, who hath been newly sealed in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, our true God. Therefore, I adjure thee, O most crafty and pure and vile, loathsome and alien spirit, by the might of Jesus Christ, who hath all power in heaven and earth, who hath said unto the dead and dumb demon, come out of man, and in no wise enter thou a second time into him. Depart, acknowledge the vanities of might, which have no power to over swine. Call to mind him who, at thy request, command thee to enter into her swine. Fear God, by whose decree the earth is established upon the waters, who hath made the heavens, and hath set upon mountains with a line, and the valleys with a measure, and hath sent into the sand for a bound to the sea, and a firm path in the mighty water, who toucheth the mountain and they smoke, who covereth himself with the light as with a garment, who stretcheth out thy heavens as with a curtain, who supporteth his chambers in the waters, who established the earth in the sureness thereof, so that it will not be turned back forever and ever, who calleth for the water of the sea, and poureth it out before the face of the earth. Be gone and depart from him who hath made himself ready for holy illumination. I adjure thee by the saving passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by his precious body and blood, and terrible coming again, for he shall come and shall not tarry to judge the whole world, and he shall chastise thee and thy confederate hosts with the fiery Gehenna, committing thee to outer darkness, where the worm ceases not and fire is not quenched. For of Christ our God is the dominion with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord of Sabaoth, O God of Israel, who healed every ailment and every wound, look upon thy servant, prove him and search him and drive him out. Out from of him all activity of the devil, rebuke the unclean spirits and expel them, and purify the works of thy hands, and exhorting the penetrating power, speedily crush down Satan upon his feet, and give him victory over him and over his foul spirits, that having obtained mercy from thee, he may be vouchsafed to thine immortal heavenly mysteries, and may send up glory to thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
enemy, receive him into thy heavenly kingdom. Open the eyes of his understanding, that the light of thy gospel may shine brightly in him. Yoke unto his life a radiant angel, who shall deliver him from every snare of the adversary, from encounter with evil, from demon, and from evil visions. Expel from him every evil impurity, impure spirit which abideth, and make it slayer in his heart. Expel from him every evil and impure spirit which hideth, and make it the slayer in his heart. Expel from him every evil and impure spirit which hideth, and make it slayer in his heart. The spirit of error, the spirit of God, the spirit of idolatry, and of every lustful desire, the spirit of deceitfulness, and every uncleanness which operate through the prompting of the devil, and make him a rational sheep in the holy flock of thy Christ, and an honorable member of thy church, a son and heir of thy kingdom, and that having lived according to thy commandments, and preserved and violated the seal, and kept his garment undefiled, he may receive the blessedness of the saints in the kingdom, through the grace and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thy most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Does thou renounce Satan and all his works and all his angels and all his service and all his pride?
I do.
Does thou renounce Satan and all his works and all his angels and all his service and all his pride?
I do.
Hast thou renounced Satan?
I have.
Hast thou renounced Satan?
I have.
Hast thou renounced Satan?
I have.
Lo, and sit upon him. Does thou unite thyself unto Christ?
I do.
Does thou unite thyself unto Christ?
I do.
Dost thou unite thyself unto Christ?
I do.
Hast thou united thyself unto Christ?
I have.
Dost thou believe in him?
I believe in him as King and God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten of our Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not made, and of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from the heavens, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man, and was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered, and was buried, and arose again on the third day according to the Scriptures, and ascended into the heavens, and sitteth at the right hand of the Father, and shall come again with glory, judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. In one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come.
Hast thou united thyself unto Christ? Hast thou united thyself unto Christ?
I have.
Hast thou united thyself unto Christ?
I have.
Bow down also before him.
I bow down before the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one essence and invisible.
Blessed is God, who willeth that all men should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
O Master, Lord our God, call thy servant George to thy holy illumination, and vouchsafe unto him the great grace that of thy holy baptism put off from him the old man, and renew him unto life eternal, and fill him with the power of the Holy Spirit and the unity of thy Christ, that he may no longer be a child of the body, but a child of thy kingdom. Through the good will and grace of thy only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thy most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Thank you.
Bless, Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the peace of the whole world, the good state of the holy churches of God, and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for this holy temple and for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter herein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our great Lord and Father, the most holy patriarch, for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Laurian, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for our Lord, the most reverend Archbishop Kirill, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the suffering Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its authorities and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this water may be sanctified through the power and action and descent of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That there may be sent down into it the grace of redemption and the blessing of Jordan, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
There they may come upon this water the purifying action of the Trinity, who is transcendent in essence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be illumined by the light of understanding and piety through the descent of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this water may prove effectual unto the diverting of every snare of enemies, both visible and invisible, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That they who are baptized therein may be worthy of the kingdom incorruptible, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who are now come unto holy illumination and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That they may prove themselves to be the sons and daughters of light and heirs of eternal good things, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That they may be members and partakers of death and the resurrection of Christ our God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
They may preserve their baptismal garment and the pledge of the Spirit, pure and blameless, unto the dread day of Christ our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this water may be to them a labor of regeneration, unto the remission of sins, and a garment of incorruption. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord God may hearken unto the voice of our supplication. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver them and us from all tribulations, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Great art thou, Lord, and marvelous are thy works. There is no word which suffices to him thy wonders. Great art thou, Lord, and marvelous are thy works. There is no word which suffices to him thy wonders. Great art thou, Lord, and marvelous are thy works. There is no word which suffices to him thy wonders. For thou, of thine own good will, hast brought into being all things which before were not. And by thy might thou dost uphold creation, and by thy providence thou dost order the world. When thou hast joined together the universe out of four elements, thou hast crowned the circle of the year with four seasons. Before thee tremble all the powers endowed with intelligence. The sun sings unto thee, the moon glorifies thee, the stars meet together before thy presence. The light obeys thee, the deeps tremble before thee, the water springs are subject unto thee. Thou hast spread out the heavens like a curtain, thou hast established the world, the earth upon the waters. Thou hast set round about the sea barriers of sand, thou hast shed abroad the air for breathing. The angelic powers serve thee, the choirs of the archangels fall down in adoration before thee. The many-eyed cherubim, the 16 seraphim, as they stand round about and fly, veil their faces in awe before thy ineffable glory. For thou art God inexpressible, existing and created before the ages, and ineffable, didst descend upon the earth, and didst take on the semblance of a servant, and was made in the likeness of man. For because of the tender compassion of thy mercy, O Master, thou couldst not endure to behold mankind oppressed by the devil, but thou didst come and didst save us. We confess thy grace, we proclaim thy mercy, we conceal not thy gracious acts. Thou hast delivered the generation of our mortal nature. By thy birth, thou hast sanctified our virgin's womb. All creation magnifies thee, who hast revealed thyself. For thou, O our God, hast revealed thyself upon the earth and hast dwelt among men. Thou hast hallowed the streams of Jordan, sending down upon them from heaven thy Holy Spirit, and hast crushed the heads of the dragons who lurk there. Wherefore, O King, who lovest mankind, come thou now and sanctify this water by the indwelling of thy Holy Spirit. Wherefore, O King, who lovest mankind, come thou now and sanctify this water by the indwelling of thy Holy Spirit. Wherefore, O King, who lovest mankind, come thou now and sanctify this water by the indwelling of thy Holy Spirit. Grant unto it the grace of redemption, the blessing of Jordan, make it the foundation of incorruption, the gift of sanctification, the remission of sins, the remedy of infirmities, the final destruction of demons, unassailable by hostile powers, filled with angelic might. Let those who would ensnare thy creature flee far from it. For we have called upon thy name, O Lord, who is wonderful and glorious and awesome unto adversaries. Let all adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign of the image of thy cross.
Let all adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign and image of thy cross.
Let all adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign of the image of thy cross. We pray thee, O God, that every arrow and obscure phantom may withdraw itself from us, and that no demon of darkness may conceal himself in this water, and that no evil spirit which instills darkening intentions and rebelliousness of thought may descend into it with they who are about to be baptized. But do thou, Master of all, show this water to be the water of redemption, the water of sanctification, the purification of flesh and spirit, the loosing of bonds, the remission of sins, the illumination of the soul, the laver of regeneration, the renewal of the spirit, the gift of adoption to sonship, the garment of incorruption, the fountain of life. For thou hast said, O Lord, wash and be clean, put away evil things from your souls. Thou hast bestowed upon us from on high a new birth through water and the spirit. Wherefore, O Lord, manifest thyself in this water, and grant that they who are baptized therein may be transformed, that they may put away from them the old man which is corrupt with the lust of the flesh, and that they may be clothed upon with the new man, renewed after the image of him who created them, that being buried after the pattern of thy death and baptism, they may in like manner be partakers of thy resurrection, and having preserved the gift of the Holy Spirit, and increased the measure of grace committed unto them, they may receive the prize of their high calling and be numbered with the firstborn whose names are written in heaven. In thee our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ. For unto thee are due all glory, dominion, honor, and worship, together with thy fathers from everlasting, thine all holy good and life giving spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And thy spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Master, Lord God of our fathers, who descend unto them that were in the ark of Noah the dove, having it in the beak of a twig and an olive, the token of reconciliation and salvation of the flood, the foreshadowing of the mystery of grace, and is provide the fruit of the olive, so the fulfilling of thy holy mysteries, who thereby fillest them that were under the law with thy Holy Spirit, and perfectest them that are under grace. Do thou thyself also bless also this holy oil with the power and operation and indwelling of thy Holy Spirit, that may be unto anointing, unto incorruption, an armor of righteousness, to the renewing of soul and body, to the averting of every assault of the devil, and deliverance from all evil, to those that shall be anointed with it in faith, or who are partakers thereof, unto thy glory, and the glory of thy only begotten Son, and thy own holy good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Let us attend.
Alleluia, alleluia.
hearing of faith.
Servant of God, Eve, is baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Spirit.
Servant of God George is baptized in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed art thou, O Lord God Almighty, source of all good things, Son of righteousness, who shineth forth upon them that were in darkness, the light of salvation, through the manifestation of thine only begotten Son and our God, who has given unto us unworthy ones blessed purification through hallowed water and divine sanctification, through life-giving chrismation, who now also has been pleased to regenerate thy servant that have been newly enlightened by water and the Spirit, and grant unto them remission of sins, whether voluntary and involuntary. Do thou thyself, O King, O Master, compassionate King of kings, grant also unto him, them the seal of the gift of the Holy and Almighty and Adorable Spirit, and the communion of the Holy Body and Precious Blood of thy Christ. Keep them in thy sanctification, confirm them in the Orthodox faith, deliver them from the evil one and from all his crafty actions, and preserve their soul in purity and uprightness through the saving fear of thee, that they may please thee in every deed and word, and may be a son and daughter of the heir of the heavenly kingdom. For thou art our God, the God who showeth mercy and saveth, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. As many as have heard of Christ,
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Master, Lord our God, who through the font bestowed heavenly illumination upon them that are baptized, who has regenerated thy newly enlightened servant by water and the Spirit, has granted unto them remission of their sins, whether voluntary or involuntary, lay thine almighty hand upon them and preserve them by the power of thy goodness. Maintain and violate the pledge of the Spirit and make them worthy of life eternal and of thy favor. For thine it is, show mercy to save, and unto thee do we send up glory together with thine unurgent Father, thy most holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And to thy Spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
Justified, thou art illumined, thou art sanctified, thou art washed in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and the Spirit of God. Thou art baptized, thou art illumined, thou art anointed with chrism, thou art sanctified, thou art washed in the name of the Father, and of the Son.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Master, Lord our God, who has honored man with thine only image and has fashioned him with a rational soul and a comely body, inasmuch as the body serveth the rational soul, for thou hast this set a head on high and endowed it with the chiefest position of the senses, which nevertheless impede not one to another, and thou coverest the head with hair, that it may not injure with the changes of the weather, and hast fitly joined together all their members with them, that he may give thanks unto thee, the great artificer, thyself, O Master, through thy chosen vessel, the Apostle Paul, has given us a commandment that we should now do all things to thy glory. Bless also now these thy servants, Bede, Nicole, and George, who are come to make a first offering shorn from the hair of their head, and likewise their sponsors, and grant that they may all meditate on thy law and do those things which are well-pleasing unto thee. For merciful God art thou, and the lover of mankind, and unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Unto thy Spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
Baptismal font, by thy goodness to sanctify them that believe on thee. Bless these children here present. Let thy blessing descend upon their heads. And as thou hast blessed David the king by the hand of the prophet Samuel, bless also the head of these thy servants, Bede, Nicole, and George, by the hand of me a sinner, inspiring them by the Holy Spirit, that as they increase in stature and even unto a ripe old age, they may ascribe glory unto thee, and behold the good things of Jerusalem all the days of their life. For unto thee art due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you.
mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our great Lord and Father, the most holy Patriarch Kirill, for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Larian, first Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for our Lord, the most reverend Archbishop Kirill, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the suffering Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the Lord our God, that he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in his firmness of mind, brotherly love, and piety.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for this land, its authorities, and armed forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, and for the salvation of the servants of God. And Gregory and Svetlana, the sponsors, and the newly illumined Bede, Nicole, and George.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God, who lovest mankind, and unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
The sermon about George is churched. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, he enters into thy house to worship towards thy holy temple. The servant of God, George, is churched. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. In the midst of the church, he shall sing praises to thee. The servant of God, George, is churched. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Now let us thou thy servant depart in peace.
Our God, our all glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Honor us.
May Christ, our true God, the prayers of his offering mother, the holy, glorious, and all praised apostles, of Saint Ruth, of our holy, the Father, Hermit of Alaska, of Saint Bede, of Saint Nicholas, and Saint, and the Holy Great Father George, of the Holy Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good, and loveth mankind.
Amen.
Congratulations. God bless you. What an indescribable joy it is to baptize a whole family together and to see the radiance of your illumination, all three of you. So it's been a wonderful year or more that we've been together studying the faith, and for it to come to this culmination is such a great joy. And I pray that this grace that has been bestowed upon you is something that you will work diligently to retain. The white garments that you're wearing are symbolic of the absolute purity of your souls at this moment. As we have discussed, when you go down into the waters, you're going down into the burial of Christ. And as you come up out of the waters, you're uniting yourself to Christ in his resurrection. And you begin a new life from this point forward, your life as Orthodox Christians. So tomorrow you will come to the Divine Liturgy. Each of you should be wearing your baptismal garments and we will have you receive the body and blood of Christ. So God bless you from the bottom of my heart. I am so incredibly joyful and feel so dearly blessed. Greg and Lana, congratulations to you as well. Godparents of a new family. And you know, your job is to watch over them spiritually, to pray for them, to be their intercessors, and to make sure that George is being brought up in the faith. Hang out with us all.
A prosperous and peaceful life, health, salvation, and good success in all things. Grant, O Lord, to thy newly ordained servants, Bede, Nicole, George, and their sponsors, Gregory and Svetlana, and preserve them for many years.
You and give our congratulations in the hall. So God bless you.